This is Mahendra from Koiter. We create virtual trial rooms. We allow customers to trial products virtually to see how they look in it. So we do it in all three channels: mobile, e-commerce, and on in-store experiences as well. So this will allow customers to trial products and take images of them and share it on the social media with their friends and families to get their feedback and make purchase decisions instantly. This will help retailers to reduce returns and prevent damage of products. Please log on to www.koiter.com to trial further. Thank you.
So here we are showcasing a smart factory system. The idea is that it's all an industrial IoT connected network. This represents here the central area, data area, where which somewhere you can remotely monitor the health of every single machine in the factory as well as different factory areas. So this we are showcasing that there is a machine connected, which is represented by a valve here, but we are monitoring six parameters of this particular things. It can be temperature, it can be current, and many other things. Over here we have got a flammable gas detector, so that is supposed to indicate that we are monitoring the state of the factory itself, so that in case there's a fire possibility, we can trigger an alarm. So we have a central alarm also here. So I think I'll just give it demo. One is we can turn on and off every machine from the central location. So this is one. Now we'll just do a demo where the in case there's a fire possibility detected. So what we are going to show there is a small flammable liquid, a drop of it near the sensor. Automatically the machine has been shut down and the alarm is triggered in the central location.
Hi, this is Ram. I head the marketing at Nimble Wireless, and this is a product. To simplify a product, this has 12 different size of sensors built into it. It has a GPS, it has a GPRS, it has a temperature, humidity, motion, proximity, ALS, all built into one single device. So this has an ALS chip here, and it has a GSM, everything built into it, and you have an RS-232 port here, and then this can be charged using a normal USB charger. This is a world-leading battery life. With this device, you can expect battery life of up to 6 to 7 months. This works on a GSM network in India and a CDMA network in the US. We are partnered with Verizon in the US for a CDMA network. And so we monitor a lot of assets, something like a reefer truck, a cold room, or a data center, a windmill. The possibility is more than you think. So you can monitor a lot of stuff using this device. We have an application known as Iris to view all this data. So once the device will monitor the data, whatever you want, temperature, humidity, whatever you want, it sends it to the cloud using the GSM data. Once in the cloud, you can pull the data using the application. So this is a normal application. It will send you alerts in the case of a temperature variation, humidity variation, or a power supply, a disconnect of a power supply, or whatever it may be. Please check out us, www.nimblewireless.com.
Hi, I'm Kaviraj, and our product is called Blueberry. To tell you about the problem first, If we look at those SMEs or small scale industries in Coimbatore, even though they are aware of the IoT and data analytics and the potential of the data analytics involved with the IoT, and they know the potential of that, still it's not being actually implemented or welcomed readily by the SMEs here in Coimbatore. That's one of the reasons being there is a large resistance offered by the workers who are actually handling the day-to-day works or have their data. Operate the day-to-day operations with machines, machineries and all. One of the reasons being that most of these workers are unskilled. They're unskilled in the sense like they're not very familiar with the latest gadgets or modern smartphone devices or which the IoT sensors you make use of, IoT system makes use of. So for them to bridge the gap, we have simplified something like a product like this. Which basically bridges that gap. So this is a simple input system where it has the feel of paper and so it kind of replaces the pen and paper which the workers are normally used to, and also is not as complicated or something as like a smartphone device which every unskilled worker will be not familiar with. So this basically with this device, this is an input device and basically like a paper, and it has a module which connects it to the cloud. And with this you can actually, for instance, one of the use case would be for a manual inspection of a machine. The board or the paper would be pasted beside the machine, and the worker can actually, you know, press touch the points where, you know, as a checklist, and this data will be in real time fed to the cloud. Or, you know, like schedule the next inspection on the date by bookmarking the date as in the calendar, or it can even call the technician in case of an emergency. Immediately can call the maintenance engineer. So things like this, the workers can constantly interact with the board where there is no, like, you know, fancy gadgets involved. So it's very straightforward for them, obvious for them, where you can just paste it. And another thing is it conserves energy because there's no touch LCD or LED involved. So there is no latency behind, you know, digitizing the pen and paper information to the cloud. So this is basically like they offers a feel and touch of the paper, and as at the same time as leverages the potential of the IoT involved in this.
I'm Ganesh Shankar, Managing Director of Luxgen Engineering Technologies. I started this company about 4 years back to solve problems in terms of energy and water problems, in terms of how we manage it. So here you can see the overall block diagram of our product, where you have multiple sources of energy and you have water. So this system actually measures the amount of water going into individual systems and segregate this value from multiple sources. Likewise, it also segregates the energy going to individual system and segregates and gives it to a centralized hub, which would do all kinds of analytics that is required for energy and water management. And likewise, make some kind of a control that would be suitable for the infrastructure. We have developed a mobile app which would actually show how much the energy consumed at individual place. Here is a simple demo model. So to showcase the product, we have made a small house kind of arrangement where we switch on the loads here, and you see how amount of energy that has been consumed by this house right now. We have put a 100 watt bulb and another 60 watt bulb, and you can see the amount of energy consumed is 160 watt here. This energy is actually showcased at the desktop level, that is a PC level, also at the app level. You can see the amount of energy that has been consumed. You can also see the waveform, and if I switch it off, it also the waveform also changes. You can see it is coming down. The total energy will come down. So this enables a user, the power and energy water user, to properly manage the resource. You can make sure that there's no the leakage is detected. If there's a water theft, that also can be detected. Even if there's some kind of a electricity theft, that will be detected. So this system, on an overall perspective, helps you manage your water and energy resource.
I'm Karthik, a director of 1B Technologies Private Limited. We developed a product called a smart home solution. That is India's first IoT-based smart home solution. Itself, it is possible to control automations like your lights, fans, and gate, whatever the things you can operate it through mobile app or remote or through manually. And also itself carries, technology carries CCTV camera solution and as well home alarm solutions. These all together control through our smart server. This smart server is designed to control all together through wireless based control and as well through mobile app based control. Through mobile app, you can control it, your home from anywhere. You can control your curtains or gate, whatever the things you have. This is our first IoT product in India. Okay. This is our smart server. This smart server controls cameras and lighting systems and as well alarm panels. Through this itself having some intelligent solutions like everyone putting cameras in their houses, but no one is checking either it is working or not. But in our solution itself check cameras, alarm systems are working or not working and itself giving feedback to your mobile. If it is not working, it give alerts every time. Simple. There is this is our remote based solution. You can operate it through remote and as well. This is our mobile application. You can control it through your you can see this. Yeah, it gets off. This through like this, you can control your gate and you can control your motors or you can control your AC. And also, these are all alarm panels. These are all alarm systems. Itself having a window sensor, door sensors, shutter sensor, and smoke detector and temperature sensors. All together, it is possible to control it through our 1B product. If you make some automation through for gate, it is possible. We have gate automation solutions also.
Myself Raja, I'm representing VR Next, and this is our first product, which is a holographic display. Holographic displays are meant for augmented reality, which can be used for displaying the products in showcases, which can attract the onlookers into customers. So basically what we have done is we have built this particular model wherein the people can put their real products into the holographic projector and start animating around it. So the use case being, say for example, you have a unique product and the product has a number of features. You can put the product inside the holographic display and you can start speaking the uniqueness of your product in terms of animations, which can attract the crowd on the street. So basically what this product can do is when there are too many competitors on the same places, you can put this in your window showcases with your product and uniqueness of your product, which will pull the crowd to your place. And this holographic display is built with interaction, which can be controlled with a mobile device. And primarily you can animate any content and you can play any 3D models. This is just one small sample use case where the 3D model of a building is interactively shown to the user. The next one. This is a model of a human heart. So, what this shows you is this is not just not only an ad or promotion material, but this can be applied to any sort of industry where you can model it and display it in the holographic projector.
Hi, this is Madan, founder at Skyware. So we are here at Forge. You know, we came for a tech demo. So what we do is we build drones, and we build smarter software for the drones, which makes them, you know, which gives them autonomous capabilities and makes them, you know, a little bit smarter than what is already there in the market. So the problem that we are working on is, you know, we are focusing on B2B side of things, you know, especially the agriculture, the agri industry, and the BIM or the urban mapping segment of the market. So, you know, I have in front of me a drone that we built indigenously in Coimbatore. So this is a, you know, quadcopter, if you can say. It has a bunch of sensors. It has, you know, it's battery powered, and it communicates to my laptop over the telemetry cable. And whatever the drone sees, you know, I can see from my laptop. And we can, you know, attach a bunch of payloads on it depending on our application. So, you know, what I have in front of my screen is a mission planner, which can, you know, let you use Google Maps to, you know, plot a certain mapping data or mapping, you know, circumference. And these instructions are sent to the drone. And using this particular remote control I have here, I can control the drone, arm it, put it in the air, and ask it to do certain information that I have given here. So the end result of it will be either one of the two outputs. The first output is, you know, NDVI map. We call it the neutral density vegetation index. So what this map shows us is a pretty good insight on the health of the plant, health of the crops. So we have like three different bands here, the green, the yellow, and the red. So the greens means the plants are pretty healthy. You know, they are going to give you a pretty good yield. The yellow means the plants are probably, you know, having some sort of difficulty, you know, maybe they are weak, they are not getting enough water, or maybe they have got some insect infestation. The red areas essentially here are problems, meaning either the plant has died there or the plant never grew, the seed never germinated. And the blue ones, you know, we can actually see where the water is being retained. So all that can be identified. So using this information, subject matter expertises can come in, and they can prescribe, you know, where to put fertilizers, you know, what amount of fertilizers to be put, where I can limit my water, you know, flow, or where I should increase my water flow, and all those kind of stuff. The main aim is to increase, you know, the yield per hectare in our farms. So that's the whole idea of the, you know, solution that we are offering to the agriculture side of things. So coming to the urban mapping side, we can create these kind of 3D maps using these drones and our software. So what it does is it takes a bunch of pictures, stitches them together over the cloud or using open source software such as, you know, Visual SFM, for example, and gives us a 3D model like this. You know, this 3D model can be, you know, used by smart city planning or, you know, BIM services or whatnot, to understand and to get a situational awareness how their landmass is going to look like. And we have a pretty good resolution also. So the ground level is, you know, much better than the satellite acquired imagery. So this is what we do essentially at Skyware, and we are basically an R&D, and we are looking to go to market in another 3 to 4 months.
Hi, I am Kiran, and I represent Protomake, and this is my colleague Vinod. You might be knowing us as the creators of India's first online marketplace for 3D printing services. Primarily, we are right now focused into creating IoT devices that can enable any 3D printer out there to be operated via the cloud. So if I can just show you a small little quick demo on what we have managed to do in the past 2 weeks, it'll be great. So what happens is I have an app that basically connects to my printer via my module that I have put it over here. So I can send out any particular file through my tablet or phone or any PC, being anywhere in the world. I can connect to my printer and I can upload a file that will enable me to send the file to my printer so that it can start the printing process. Apart from that, I can even calibrate and move my printer's head to whichever location I would want them to move. A quick demo of that would be like this. So as you can see that I have micro level of control of my printer via the cloud. I don't have to be physically present where my printer is. I do not have to manually operate it. At the touch of a button, at anywhere in the world, I can control my printer. So essentially what we are trying to do over here is enable people with printers in their home be connected to our platform, and where we as professional engineers who would have more control of what kind of objects or what kind of models needs to be printed, we can calibrate it and then send it over to the people who own a printer without expertise and get our job, the print job done. So this is the kind of expertise that we are trying to bring to the masses, which is usually very restrained and constrained in the usual sphere. Apart from that, we are enabling engineering services to come up with prototypes. We have helped a lot of startups in and around Bangalore, Chennai, and Gujarat to come up with, you know, hardware-based startups and prototypes that would take them a lot of time if they went through a conventional way. We have essentially cut-shorted the time between the design and, you know, the go-to-market phase using our resources and our engineering, back-end expertise that we provide our customers. And as a fun part of things, we have also come up with the concept of deskies, which are essentially miniature versions of yourself. So what I'm holding in my hand right now is a deskie, and this is of my colleague Vinod, if you can zoom in and you can see it. This is available all over India. We have essentially tied up with various print partners, or scan partners will go out, where you can go out and get yourself scanned, and where you can get your 3D printed model out there as a deskie. So in short, that's all about us. Thank you.